Welcome to iLecture Online, and here's another example of how we find the center of mass. In its case, we're going to find the center mass of the Earth-Moon system. All right, so we need to know a little bit about the Earth and the Moon. Let's draw the Earth right here, and let's draw the Moon over here. Now, of course, that's not proportionally in size or distance, but just for our benefit, there it is. And so you can imagine that they're connected by some invisible rod that has no mass. And so taking those two objects put together, might as well label them. Here's our Earth. Here's our Moon. Where would the center of mass be between those two? So let's put them on a coordinate system. And to make things easy, let's put the origin on the coordinate system right here at the very center of the Earth. So there's the y-axis, there's the x-axis. And you can right away see that since both the Moon and the Earth are on the x-axis, we don't have to worry about the y direction. So the center mass in the y direction will simply be zero. We only worry about the center of mass in the x direction. So using our equation, the center mass in the x direction is equal to the sum from I equals 1 to n, in this case n is 2, there's only two objects, of the product of the masses of each times the x coordinate of the center mass of each, and divide that by the sum of the two masses from I equals 1 to n. In this case, of course, n is equal to 2. So now we go ahead and plug in what these things are. And I'm going to need a little bit more room, so I'm going to move over here. The center mass in the x direction is equal to the product of the masses times their x coordinates of their center masses. So mass of the Earth, so mass of the Earth, and that would be times zero, because the Earth, the way we put it, is right at the origin, center mass at the origin, so there's no x coordinate, plus the mass of the Moon multiplied times the distance from the Earth to the Moon in the x direction, which happens to be 385,000 kilometers, which is 385 million meters. So 385 times 10 to the 6th meters, and divide that by the sum of the two, which is the mass of the Earth plus the mass of the Moon. All right, so now we still have to plug in the mass of the Earth and the Moon. Obviously here we don't, because that's already zero. So this is equal to the mass of the Moon, which is equal to 7.35 times 10 to the 22nd kilograms. We multiply that times 385 times 10 to the 6th meters. That's 386 million or 385 million meters. And then divide that by the sum of the mass of the Earth, which is 5.98 times 10 to the 24th kilograms. Added that to the mass of the Moon, which is 7.35 times 10 to the 27th kilograms. All right, now we're going to need a calculator. If I can find mine, there it is. All right, so let's put the denominator together, 5.98 e to the 24th, add that to 7.35, exponent 22nd equals, that's our denominator, so take the inverse of that, and there's my inverse button, and I multiply it times the mass of the Moon, and then multiply that times the distance to the Moon. And, 4,675 kilometers. That's 4,765 kilometers, which is equal to 4.765 times 10 to the 6th meters. Of course, we don't want to express that in terms of meters. 4 millimeters, 4,000 kilometers, that's about right. Okay, so where's the center mass? Well, the radius of the Earth is about 6,378 kilometers. So if the center mass of the Earth-Moon system is only 4,765 kilometers, which means it's somewhere inside the Earth, the center mass between the Moon and the Earth is right over there. Now that's kind of an interesting fact, because we always think that the Moon circles the Earth, but in fact, the Moon circles the center mass of the Earth-Moon system, and so does the Earth. So as the Moon goes around the Earth, or more technically speaking, around the center mass of the Moon-Earth system, so does the Earth. So the Earth goes into small little circles around the center mass when the Moon goes around that very same center mass. And when you think about it, the result of that is when, of course, if this is the sun right here, and this is the earth with the moon, and as the moon goes around the center mass between the earth-moon system, so does the earth go around. So instead of the earth going around nice little ellipses around the sun, the earth actually does something like this. So every time the moon goes around the earth goes around the center of mass between the earth-moon system. And so the earth is kind of constantly wobbling back and forth, a little bit farther, a little bit closer, a little bit farther, a little bit closer from that nice smooth ellipse we thought the earth was traveling on. All right? So that's the result of that. That's how you find the center mass of the earth-moon system. All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, thank you. Yeah, well, that's better. Thank you.